okay, I'm going to talk about the movie Precious and how black people are portrayed in the media. I'm also going to talk about this new movie, Machete, which is stirring up a great deal of controversy. First, when I was growing up, I grew up in a mostly African-American environment, but I was very disconnected from the environment that I was growing up in. At various points, I spent time in dangerous neighborhoods, and I was really exposed to a lot of negative elements within my own community. So that, along with the media portrayals of blacks, it really gave me a really skewed perception of the African-American community. And for a while, I was only really into white girls. And as I got older and I started to get a broader view of the world, and I started to question the media's portrayals of blacks and the media in general, you know, I started to have a broader perspective. And, you know, to this day, a lot of my friends think that I'm only attracted to white women. And, you know, they're kind of surprised when I say that Kelly Rowland is hot, when I talk about Megan Good, when I talk about Gabrielle Union and women like that. You know, I definitely realize my shortcomings, and when I was younger, I was very unhappy with who I was as a person. I wasn't very comfortable being a black man, and as I grew older, I started to understand part of the reasons why I felt that way. And once you start to change the way you view the media, and a lot of the messages that are sent your way, it sort of changes the way you view yourself. So I'm at a point in my life where I'm happy to be the black man that I am. And I just started to think about this lately because I saw this movie called Precious. And I was listening to this one guy on MacLessons.com or something. His name is Elite. He was talking about how black people are portrayed in film and on television. And he theorized that the reason why a lot of white people like movies like Precious is because they show black people who are basically miserable. And there's a lot of white people who like to watch black people who are miserable because they think, well, gee, I'm glad that's not me type of mentality. And I thought it was an interesting observation. But, you know, I think that, you know, it's not just white people. I think it's a lot of people like to watch movies like that because they think that, oh, gee, I'm glad that's not my life or anything like that. But Elite talked about how Precious was very popular with white people and how after the film was made, Lionsgate actually talked Oprah and Tyler Perry into signing on to the movie as executive producers as a means of earning credit among blacks. And he also commented on the title itself, which is Precious, based on a novel pushed by Statfire. I always wonder why they came up with that weird title, because it didn't really make much sense to me. But then, you know, when you think about it, the title does let you know that, hey, you know, this movie is being made by a black person. This movie is based on a novel by a black person. So I guess it was sort of designed to sort of take some of the steam, some of the heat off of the filmmakers. And I think that Daniel Lee, who made the film, I think he seems like a pretty decent guy. I think he made the film for the right reasons, but I think the film is sort of, it still has sort of a negative impact on how black people are viewed. And Lee talked about this movie Boomerang and how virtually all the characters were black professionals and the white people were basically assistants to these black people, and how a lot of critics didn't like it because it showed black people in a position where they were not inferior to white people. I also thought that was pretty interesting as well. I don't know, what do you guys think about that? Do you think that white people get a kick out of seeing movies in which black people are depressed or black people are miserable? I mean, I think a lot of people, not just white people, a lot of people in general get a kick out of that. But then again, a lot of people may have just enjoyed the movie for, I don't know if you can use the word enjoy, but they probably appreciated the film for its story and its acting. But personally, I didn't really see the point to the film. I mean, the ending, there was something good about it, but it seemed pretty hopeless to me. It seemed pretty depressing to me. This movie is probably the most depressing film I've ever seen in my entire life. You know, the whole phenomenon where people watch these miserable black people, I don't think it's really so much of a race thing, because it sort of reminds me of the Saw movies, you know, and Hostel. Now, I think that people sort of enjoy a certain misery of others on film. I think it's part of the reason why people watch Daredevils. You know, those stunt devils, those stunt guys jump off the cliff on a motorcycle and all kinds of crazy stuff. You know, because a lot of people, they watch that stuff just to see if that guy's going to crash and burn. the movie Machete, which is something that Alex Jones is talking about a lot now, it's based on this joke trailer that was a part of the Grindhouse series. They released two movies that part of this. It was all one release. Two movies, one release. It's called Grindhouse. One movie was Planet Terror. Another one was this car slasher film called Bulletproof. And they were both supposed to be B-movie-like throwbacks. You know, horror throwbacks. And basically, Machete's being... It's a movie about this Latino who declares war against these racist whites. And I haven't seen the movie yet. I've only seen the trailer. But in the beginning of the trailer, Machete starts off and says something to the tune of, "This is for you people in Arizona." Then we start to see all this bloodshed and all this craziness. You know, I was actually looking forward to this movie, really. But the timing, you know, the timing is suspect. And I think it's really important that Robert Rodriguez really handles this film in a way that makes it seem funny and interesting and smart and provides good social commentary. Because if he doesn't do a good job, it could come off as being pretty racist. So, I don't know. You guys tell me what you think about all these movies. If there's one thing we can learn is that movies are more powerful than people think.